Yeah. You know, he wrote a lot of stuff. One of Symphonies, a lot of concertos. But he also wrote Violin Sonatas. And what we're going to play for you is the 9th Violin Sonata, A major, called a Kreutzer. Now, the background to the title Kreutzer is for a violinist by the name of Kreutzer. So when Beethoven was composing this work, typically Beethoven is known for being like a perfectionist, you know, after that genius comes in. He always scribbled things and had to rewrite it and make it better. And he was supposed to perform with a violinist by the name of George Bridgetower. And they were supposed to perform in Vienna, and the morning of, he finally finished it. The performance was at 8 o'clock a.m. Well, poor George Bridgetower. He got the music without being able to practice, without being able to look at it, without being able to watch it on YouTube. Yeah. Just performing on the spot. He had to read off of the manuscript that Beethoven had to write in ink. So, for Beethoven, he played on the piano. He's okay, because it's on his head the whole time. You know, as any violinist would know, trying to sight read through this difficult sonata probably didn't go well for Mr. George Bridgetower. So after the performance, they went to a bar, had some drinks, too much drinks, and they got in an argument to where Beethoven got so upset that he removed his name off the manuscript. So he should not call the Bridgetower Sonata, and he dedicated to Rudolf Kreutzer, who was a violinist that he's only known like a couple times. Beethoven is like, here, I'm just gonna put your name on, be happy. And Kreutzer looked at it and he said that it was outrageously unintelligible piece of music. That he didn't even dare to perform it or learn it. So for us modern musicians, doesn't make sense why we have to put our sweat and blood into this difficult work when the person who Beethoven dedicated this to never even touched it. So this violin sonata, you know, it's a three-movement work. It's one of the unique work where the piece starts with a slow introduction, and then it just goes blazing fast. And then the second movement, you have a theme and variation, which is something that Beethoven really got into later in his life, in that middle late period. And then the last movement is a cheery, joyful tarantella. Now, for those who don't know what tarantella is, it's a kind of dance where people believed that people were bitten by venomous spiders, that they would have to dance like crazy to get the poison out. So we'll do our best to not play frantically. But it is a kind of dance that is fairly quick. So I hope you enjoy Beethoven's Violin Sonata number 9, the Bridgetower Kreutzer Sonata.
Thank you. we've got another one. This is our second half encore. We're going to play Nocturne number 20 by Frédéric Chopin. Also, originally written for solo piano and transcribed by the same violinist, Nathan Milstein, from that same collection. This piece has a connection to the film The Pianist from 2002, directed by Roman Polanski. This is the piece that the main character, Vladislav Shpilman, plays in order to get hiding and food from a German army officer. And this parallels the historical event of when the Germans were taking over Poland, the last piece to be played on radio in 1939 on Polish national radio was this nocturne, and it was performed by that pianist. It's actually also connected to another Holocaust survivor, Natalia Karp. She performed this piece for her concentration camp commander, and he was so affected that he spared her life. So here is Nathan Milstein's transcription of Chopin's Nocturne number 20.
title of this concert is called A Major Work for the Virtuosic Violin. And you may have heard our two largest pieces, the Fourier, Beethoven, those were both in A major key. So we thought, you know, let's go back to the fundamentals of violin. So if you think about little kids who are learning violin for the first time, taking the Suzuki program, some of those going through those, they always kind of teach the kids the key of A major as the first basic fundamental key for kids to learn. And so we're just gonna snatch one of the songs from the Suzuki book and present it for you. Don't think you need to know the name. Figure it out. Enjoy it.